One of the highlights is coming up in just a minute or so's time. It's time now to check the prediction leaderboard. Our headmaster in this department has been David King, ably assisted by Jared Healy. There have been calls for audits right throughout the season. They've gone unheard. So what have you got, Kingy, as far as our leaderboard is concerned?
Yeah, we had a couple of audits throughout the course of the season. Mark Thompson wasn't happy. Time and time again, he wasn't happy. So the 4-20 predictions, Jared, we did them every Friday night pre-game. The boys put themselves on the line, wild or sensitive. They were all ranging. And here's your winner. Ben Dixon's won it. Small sample, Jared.
He's in the war room three times.
75%. You come second there. Very good effort. Jason Dunstall finished strong with 62. Lynchy just behind him. Be disappointed with that. Dermot took
it
very
serious. He's had some up and downs, Dermot.
He sung most of the year, which was fantastic. Ed will be filthy with that. He'll want to account back on that for sure. I'm just behind him. Now, Bomber, there's a dispute still. There's a little asterisk next to Bomber. He's still not happy about 54.
He wants the integrity department to come in.
The mayor of Adelaide dropped in a couple of times for 54.
What the spreadsheet, boys? What the spreadsheet? Where's the spreadsheet?
Still chasing that spreadsheet. That's about three spreadsheets you're looking for now. Brad Johnson just under 50%. I'm not sure how he got that high.
He just kept smiling, so he got a couple of extras.
He kept smiling. This is where the real problem is. Jonathan Brown was going beautifully. Yep. It was panels in front at the halfway mark. Then start tipping against the key power forwards.
He's tipped two out of eight finals.
Sandy, I can't believe, is on 47% because he stopped trains this year.
He stopped the tide a couple of times.
He was unbelievable. And Sellers has come third last, which is a good effort from him because he tried to get across most weeks. But there's your Spooners, equal Spooners, Cam Mooney
marvellous.
And Barry Hall. And Sandy, as you know, the punishment, because you know it because you were in the gun there for a while, was to turn up today and put on the best vocals you can provide.
Good on you, Kingy. Yes, well, they're just about set. Before we introduce them, though, let's have a look at our two singers in action as far as predictions are concerned throughout the season.
For me, it's Luke Parker. Parker unzipped. If I had a daughter, I'd let him date her. That's how much I like him.
Eight clearances, unfortunately, can't give you that one.
Can't date my daughter anymore.
Can't date you. I don't think he'd want to anyway, let's be honest.
Sam Reed and Adam Goodsey, look around the forward 50 and they're going to say exactly this.
Cash. There's no cash here. Here, there's no cash, all right? Cash, no. Robbo?
No cash.
Bloody Franklin, Kurt Tibbett out of the side. All the cash is gone. The Swans will still kick 100 points.
The cross for your selection. You went for 100 points and they kicked 94. Moons was leading this competition 3 weeks ago. Now he's down with Sandy with the potential to be singing on grand final day.
There's an old show back in town, boys, tonight. And I went and bought everyone some tickets to the Stevie J show. Five goals for my man.
You printed up tickets. You bought props. It was fantastic. But he hasn't kicked five goals for the best part of 3 years.
No. My prediction tonight is Ryder brings the storm.
I wasn't sure how that went, so I went to the stats. In the first quarter, he exploded with one handball.
Has anybody ever had a triple-triple before?
I'll tell you what. Well, I don't think we've seen one of those.
So it's going to be Moons and Hawley on grand final day.
If I get restless, Fazzy, you're not that kind.
Excellent.
Don't go breaking my heart. You take the weight off of me. Oh, honey, when you knock on my door, honey, I give you my key. Ooh, ooh. Nobody knows it. Down. I was your clown. Ooh, ooh.
Come on, everyone, join in.
Nobody knows it.
Nobody knows it.
When I was down,
I was your clown.
Mate, Meatloaf look absolutely outstanding, we did.
Good on you, Moons. Bit of fun with Cameron Mooney and Barry Hall. Let's thank them once again,
That's outstanding. 15 years, great careers each, premierships and reputations destroyed in
and
15
now remembered,
seconds.
Remembered forever.
That's how they will be remembered.
No one would have recorded that, though.
We won't replay.
No, won't replay. I feel bad.
We've got it all on tape, so we'll take a break.
Well done, boys.
And be back with more. Yeah? Well done, guys.
You're watching Grand Final Day on Fox. Pre-game. Brought to you by Mazda BT50.
You don't really look too far forward at the beginning. You know, I knew we'd improve quite a bit over the summer. And we've built a lot over the season as well, so probably it hasn't sunk in, you know, this early in the week, but it feels like we've just got another game of footy, which is good.
We had a pretty strong finish to the end of last year, and, you know, we're pretty disappointed not to make finals. You know, it was our own fault we didn't make it. So this year we really trained hard. You know, we started to learn Simo's game plan a little bit better as well. And that cohesion of the group has built pretty strong throughout the year, and we finished it off pretty strong, and to be able to play in the grand final has been a pretty big surprise.
We obviously had that first loss, and as the season progressed, you know, everyone started to really gel together, and the chemistry came together with the boys and the game plan, and yeah, here we are.
Well, the moment is drawing nearer as thousands continue to win their way inside the MCG as they get ready for the grand final entertainment, and then, of course, the big clash, the 2015 AFL Toyota Grand Final. Nice to welcome Barry Hall in all seriousness to the panel. Put our hands together for Baz.
Well, Baz.
Good work, mate. Hello, boys.
Well done. Just had a text from Elton John. I can tell you he's not happy.
Oh, no doubt. It was absolutely putrid. It went exactly the way I thought it would.
I thought you looked pretty comfortable, actually.
Yeah, Moon's dragged me down a little bit. I thought I was the best performer out of the two of us.
Smile on your face. You're everything a performer needs to be out.
Well, look, I'm an entertainer, and that's what I do. I wasn't a fish out of water up there.
No, Moon's got into it far too much for my liking. Yeah, he actually really enjoyed it.
He loves me and Kicky D.
Bass, won't go there. Your grand final moment, mate. What is it, if you had one memorable moment?
Yeah, look, I'm self-indulgent myself, holding up the Premiership Cup. I used to dream about that as a kid. We used to kick the footy around the back paddock as a kid. I had a block of wood as my Premiership Cup, so I would have loved to have a photo of both of those things, but one of my proudest moments in life in general.
There we go.
To do both of those things as a kid growing up, to hold a block of wood as a Premiership Cup and then do the real thing, very honoured.
Yeah, no, fantastic. Final teams are in. Let's go to John Ralph now, if there are any changes, and the subs. Ralphie, what have you got for us?
Hello, Sandy. No late changes as we flagged an hour ago, and as we did suggest to you, Matt Suckling is the Hawthorn sub and Matt Rosa is the West Coast sub. Now, we know Rosa had 26 touches only 3 weeks ago, and of course, two massive goals in the prelim for Suckling. So if both of these guys get on halfway through the third quarter, let's hope this game is alive. They'll be very much ready to do business.
Good on you, Ralphie. Thanks again for your support and your work. The Hawthorn lineup, no major surprises, although some people are suggesting on our panel earlier today that they thought Hawthorn, with Schoenmakers remaining in, could be a little tall. Hawthorn, Lynchie, you've got the Hawthorn lineup.
Yeah, the Hawthorn lineup, they look very potent, and certainly Schoenmakers been their best forward over the last couple of weeks with those 15 marks, kicked 3 goals. Down back, there's just so secure, and that, when we talk about the uncontested marks, it's on the back of their run off halfback, in particular from Birchall and Burgoyne and Gibson. And I think probably Stratton played extremely well on Darling in the qualifying final. I think he'll probably start on Darling, held him to one disposal for 3/4 of a game. And what tends to happen, they have a spare down back, because what the West Coast Eagles will do, they'll push an extra forward up into the midfield to allow that very dangerous back line to get up and going. So I think that's going to be critical, and that's the area of the game that needs to be won for Hawthorn if they're to win the game.
And we're going to see the unsociable Hawks right from the word go, and that first 10 minutes could be brutal.
I think there's no doubt about that. I mean, they'll try to impose themselves, their experienced campaigners. They know exactly what happened and what worked for them last year. They'll set the standard, and the bar will be very high early, but that's not to suggest that the West Coast Eagles won't respond.
It's not like you're going to catch West Coast by surprise. They know what's coming,
guys. Their
challenge is to match it, if not win that battle.
Absolutely, and look, to come into a grand final with an unchanged lineup and very settled, no better place to be. Hawthorn had a few issues, but the lineup's pretty settled for West Coast point.
Gunston's going to be an interesting one to see how he starts. As Baz, have a look at the West Coast lineup.
Yeah, well, as I said, they're pretty settled. Hearn's been a really unheralded player down there. He just sticks their defence together. Schofield's been a player, but it's in the centre of the ground where it's going to be won or lost. Nick Natanui, he's going to be a hand above all the ruckmen in Hawthorn's point of view. If you give first option to Shuey, Prittis and Gaff, it's not a bad start. But the forward line as well, very, very dangerous. Darling, Kennedy, Lacroix, Cripps. But I reckon Josh Hill's the one for me. If they can squeeze a goal or two out of him, he's an X-factor player in the forward half for me. I reckon they're really dangerous and they're in for a fair chance. It's the first 10 minutes, which we spoke about. They've got to try and settle their lineup.
And that was Rosa, the sub, too, by the way.
Yeah, had him named on the wing. Yep. So, yeah, it's going to be critical in that around that midfield. Jack Darwin hasn't had a big year. Obviously started very late, coming halfway through the season. He's kicked a bag of five. I think he's going to have to play a role tonight for today for the West Coast Eagles as well. We know his defensive pressure is really good, but he's going to have to impact the scoreboard as well.
Barry, your tip and your Norm Smith medalist.
Well, I think Hawthorne, look, they've been there, they've done that. I just think the experience is going to give them over the line. 22 points, so I reckon they'll do it close enough, but it won't be comfortable. And I think Grant Birchall has been in really good form. I think off the halfback, he'll give them plenty of drive and be the best of field.
Good on you, Baz. Thanks for that. We're going to take a break. It has been an extraordinary year in many ways, none the least of which there's been plenty of emotion.
Hold on to me. Don't let me go. Who cares what they see? Who cares what they know? Man's right flower. It's an every living thing. Mind, use your power. Spirit, use your wings. Freedom! 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 Freedom!
I love this moment. I like this.
This is what you live for as a coach.